Hello, everyone. My name is Jose. I'm the founder of Farfetch. We are a platform company, so we are not a retailer. We don't hold any inventory. We're also not just a marketplace. So we provide businesses, brands, luxury brands and luxury boutiques with a platform where they can connect seamlessly to consumers worldwide, but crucially, we also provide them with an API, a programming language, essentially, where they can tap on our resources and logistics and build their own websites and their own businesses. So just a quick introduction to the luxury market. It's a very interesting market in terms of the asymmetry of supply and demand. The largest markets are the US and China. China, if you include the Chinese shopping abroad, is actually 30% of sales. North America is 23% of sales. The rest of APAC, Korea, Japan, Australia, Southeast Asia is 21% of sales, around 19% in Europe, 8% in the rest of the world. So it's a completely globalized market. But from the supply, it's pretty much coming from Europe. So from the top 10 brands, luxury brands, they're all European. If you take the top 30, 95% will be European and a very few American. So what this means is that we have an opportunity as an European business to really seize global demand with the advantage of being close to the supply. And that's what allows us to penetrate markets such as China. China is our second largest market after the US, where we do around 10% of sales. I guess I should have a separate slide on China, because yesterday we announced big partnership with JD.com, China's largest retailer, e-commerce company by revenue. They have become one of our main shareholders in a $400 million deal, and we plan to accelerate with them our development in that market. So our model works in a very unconventional way. We connect physical inventories in hundreds of physical shops, be it boutiques or brands, to consumers worldwide. So this is a visualization, this next video, of the story of Farfetch in parcels. Each little dot being a product going from a shop, either a brand or a boutique, to a final customer. So as you can see, it's a completely distributed model. No centralized warehouses, although we can ship from warehouses. That's the easy part. We're a bit like open table for luxury brands and boutiques. We have real-time visibility of inventory. And then we have the logistics capabilities of picking up and delivering and handling the returns to 190 countries. So what we do for our partners, we pretty much take care of everything. So integration with all their inventory, which provides unrivaled assortment in the industry. Logistics, global logistics, custom clearance, packaging, materials, etc. Payments, and this means localized payments in dozens of markets. Traffic, obviously, bringing customers and eyeballs to our platform. Localization, we now operate in 9 languages, including, obviously, Chinese, Japanese, Korean, but also German, French, Spanish, etc. We take care of customer service. We do not outsource any customer service. We need to provide our consumers with an impeccable experience compatible with the luxury industry. And finally, we operate an omni-channel platform, which means that we enable the boutiques and the shops to offer services such as click and collect in store, return in store, and other omni-channel services. So a quick look in terms of numbers. So last year, we did $800 million in gross sales. We're growing very fast, over 70% year on year. We're keeping that growth this year, so we'll do north of $1.3 billion in GMV. It's a very high average order value, $700. We have a very young millennial customer in terms of luxury, so 36 years old on average. And one in every three customers is a man. So we've become the number one shopping destination online for full price in-season luxury. Again, with 9 localized sites, we're adding Italian, so it will be 10, a nice round number next week. And we have 1,500 employees, will be 2,000 by at the end of the year. So we've been growing very fast. 2 years ago, we were number 3. This chart is the Alexa ranking of the top luxury, full-price luxury department store, the top e-commerce pure play, and Farfetch. So we're the red line. And as you can see, we've really been gaining market share, growing at 70%. Year on year consistently. So what's next? This map is actually a visualization of all the routes that we operate. So from every supply country to every demand country. And we really wanted to leverage our business model and the uniqueness of this distributed network and turn it into an advantage. We did a study together with Bain, and we found that for luxury customers, the number one criteria for buying online is timely delivery, which is really interesting. So it's not actually range, although range comes number 2. It's not price, that comes number 3. It's not customer service or packaging. Packaging comes actually way down the least. I think people are more aware of sustainability and they want simpler packaging these days. Number one criteria, timely delivery. So we got together with one of our partners, Gucci, and we sat down with them and started thinking on ways on how to leverage their amazing retail presence worldwide. And we suggested a challenge to them. Why don't we power Gucci 90 minutes delivery in 10 cities all around the world? And so Marco Bizzarri and the team, they were very excited. We started working on integrating the Gucci flagship stores, and they are gigantic, some of them, with very complex systems. It's a $6 billion company, actually growing at 40% year on year, so very successful. Luxury brand, and it was a very, very exciting innovation project for them. So that's what we did, and I have a short video to illustrate what could be fashion emergencies happening in Tokyo and London and LA. So what's next in terms of innovation? So we have a program called Star of the Future, which is part of our augmented retail vision. So we believe that although 70% of decisions are already influenced by digital, 92% of sales still happen in physical shops. The way these physical shops operate has to change. At the moment, we collect no data, and we offer no personalized experience to these customers. In a nutshell, Star of the Future is a suite of in-store technologies we've presented in London on April the 12th, which allows for a single view of data, not just online and across devices, but also in the offline world. And this means tracking and offering personalized customer experiences through data in all our network of physical stores. We're launching in Browns, our boutique we've acquired in London, and in Thom Browne in New York by the end of the year. And we really believe this is the next step in retail. Thank you very much.